pitching, what do you think is the biggest difference in your, the way you're pitching now versus maybe this time a year ago?
I'd say just the relaxed easiness, just not trying to do too much, and just staying within my mechanics and just worrying about throwing strikes, I guess, not really trying to overthrow or do anything special.
Coach Toronto said that he was kind of tinkering with your mechanics a little bit in the fall, but that didn't work out, and then you kind of fixed it and kind of went back to basics. What did he kind of have you trying? What didn't work, and how did you kind of get everything, I guess, straightened out?
We were just working on some stuff with helping me stay back, maybe separating my hands a little earlier. Just stuff that, I don't know, just for whatever reason, it didn't really work out. And then at the end of the fall, he just kind of said, you know, just go back to pitching, just go back to being you. And that's what I did, and it just helped me. It just cleared my mind, and I went back just trying to do what I was supposed to do and throw the ball where I'm supposed to throw it.
Obviously, you've always had the advantage of having, you know, really good stuff, and the issue's always been control. How do you feel like you're improving that? What are some of the things that you're trying to do to make sure that you're, you know, throwing more strikes, getting ahead of counts?
I told him, just kind of like staying under control, not doing too much, and just my sole focus is just throwing the ball where it's supposed to be thrown, not really worrying about mechanical stuff or anything other that I shouldn't be worrying about than just competing, I guess.
Do you feel like this is the best your control's been since you've been in college?
In terms of
how you're throwing it right
now? I mean, it's always a work in progress, but I mean, yeah, I definitely feel like it's the best it's been. I mean, my misses when I'm missing are down, they're not up. I'm not, you know, throwing, spraying balls up in the zone or anything. They're all been down, so it's a work in progress, but it's been just getting better and better, so.
Coach has said that he's seen progress over his tenure here. As you guys head into this season, there's a lot of expectations on this team. But he said consistency is the thing that's been missing, consistency in the wins and losses. How do you guys achieve that? What do you work on to achieve that?
I'd say just consistency in everything we do. You know, just school-wise, cleaning stuff up, just little things like that. And that carries over to just being consistent on the field, taking care of the little things on the field, you know, not missing signs, not base running mistakes, you know, consistently throwing strikes. I think all those things go together, and that's what he preaches to us all the time. And I think that's the biggest thing for us, to just be consistent, is, you know, just doing everything right that we can, and then hopefully the things will fall into place.
Do you feel like you guys are at that level of consistency as you get ready to start this season?
I think this team is definitely, we try to do everything to the best of our ability. I mean, we just try to do everything right as a unit, and we know what's right and what's wrong and what we should be doing, and we hold each other accountable more than ever since I've been here. So,
you obviously got moved around a little bit last year in terms of role. You know, sometimes you spend the back end, you know, a long guy out of the pen, did some starting. It seems like you're going to be, you know, starting in the starting rotation to come out. I guess, how comfortable do you feel about that, and do you feel like you're in sort of good shape for that role right now?
I feel real comfortable with it. I mean, I feel like I should have been doing that all along, to be honest with you, but, you know, it hasn't worked out that way. I've bounced around. I've gotten to experience a lot of different roles, different situations. But, I mean, I feel like I'm definitely ready to just be that starter like I should have been for a while now, and just, you know, go out there once a week and give my team the best chance they can have.
What do you think is just important for you to maintain that role? I mean, obviously you talked about just controlling and throwing your stuff and everything, but to be able to be consistent for six innings, you know, six, seven innings, whatever it might be, what are some of the things that you've got to do to make sure that you can do that, that you can, you know, give that sort of longevity?
I'd say just stay with what I've been doing. You know, when we've been facing guys this spring in the cages, if the weather's bad or out here, and, you know, when not trying to be too fine with my stuff, I guess, just, you know, consistently just throwing the ball down, because when I'm throwing all my pitches down just for strikes, not even trying to get nasty with anything, they don't take good swings off of it at all. And that's what I've learned, is that I don't need to be too fine with everything, and I'll be my best and most consistent when I just stay down in the zone and just really just throw strikes. I mean, just use my stuff and let it work for me.
Who else has impressed you on the staff so far? Coach has talked a lot about the depth that you guys have here. Who else has stood out to you so far?
You know, there's a lot of guys. I'd say everyone has grown up since last year, and, you know, we've added some new guys. But, I mean, I'd say definitely Zach Warren has really come on. You know, he's really matured from last year, and he's a great competitor. He's going to go out there and compete his butt off every time, and he's really grown up since last year and really kind of come into his own like we thought he was going to last year. And then Lipinski at the end of the game closing for us, he's a huge addition, junior college guy, and he's a great competitor, and you know that when he goes out there, he's going to give you the best chance to close out the game.
Andy talked a little bit about him. Just what makes John fit that role, basically, in terms of just being a back-end guy?
He's just kind of in his personality, I guess. Just kind of that gritty mentality. Like, when he's going to be in, he's going to go in there, pump strikes, and close it out for us. I mean, that's just kind of his personality, the way he is. He's just kind of a hard-nosed guy. And, I mean, I think when he's going to go out there, you're going to know the game's going to be over.